armadura de acero, rumbero bueno yo vine con armadura de acero, porque me siento capaz, porque yo soy un sonero, porque me siento capaz, porque yo soy un sonero. No soy improvisado, yo te canto con cadencia, no, 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 y no soy improvisado, porque canto con la clave, tú cantas atravesado, porque canto con la clave, ya tú ves, tú cantas atravesado.
Welcome back to Gray's Rooftop Smokes. Yes, I know it's been a while. I've been lazy over the summer months. Been smoking a lot, but not doing a lot of reviews. So this is for everyone who's been waiting. The FT-127 series. It is 5-inch long, 54 gauge, all the way from Nicaragua. We do have a Maduro wrapper on it. It's Ecuadorian. If you can see the cap there on that, or sorry, the cap and then the foot. There we go. I'm gonna cut this, light it up, give you a review. Be right back. All right, folks. Right off the bat, this cigar is extremely spicy. A lot of pepper, right off the draw. As you can see, the ash is working on half an inch of ash there, and it's sort of splitting at the end. Oh well. This is a really good cigar. I have nothing really bad to say about it. The construction is fairly well done on it. It does have a very leathery feel to it. There's inside the cap. Nothing funky going on there. Starting to mellow out a little, but it's still there. Let me show you. Yeah, still a lot of pepper in that. Some hints of cocoa or dark chocolate flavors, but strong spice and pepper. Tatuaje. 5-inch, 54 gauge. These will run you about $6 a piece, or about $148 US a box, depending where you get it. Anyway, let me get to the halfway point and see if this changes. Rooftop Smokes. We'll be back. Rooftop Smokes is back. We're getting down to the halfway mark, working on an inch and a half ash. Ash is holding up fairly well, despite that split in the middle. Still, the flavors are very consistent throughout. The pepper's starting to come back a bit, so is the spice. I still get that strong hint of, dark chocolate or cocoa flavor. Pretty good. The draw is quite smooth on it. I don't have any issues with the draw. Smoke generation's pretty silky smooth. A lot of smoke generation off this as well. Let's test it out. I don't know if you can see. I can't see. It's pretty bright here in Seoul. But yeah, let me get down to the band and the finger burn part and see if this intensifies anymore or not. All right, Rooftop Smokes. We'll be back. And welcome back, everyone. I know it's been a while. Good to see everyone. Well. Can I really see you? Anyway, thanks for watching. Stay tuned. I'll be back momentarily. Welcome back to Rooftop Smokes. Again, still consistent throughout. Pepper, spice, that dark chocolate flavor. And the band came off flawlessly. I wanted to show you guys. One-handed it. There you go, folks. I'm going to finger burn this and enjoy the rest of it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Just to give you an idea, if I can flip this around without dropping it. The construction on this, as I said before, was really well done. They have a triple cap here, and that held up very well. Just want to mention that as well. It's a beautiful day here in Seoul. It is September 13th. Happy Friday, I guess. TGIF. May luck be with you today. Just to give you a shot of the sky and soul. It's gorgeous. That's not gorgeous. If you know my earlier videos, that building wasn't there. That popped up over the summer, thus blocking my wonderful, semi-wonderful view of the city, as it were. Anyway, I'm glad to be back. Glad to be doing a review. Glad you're watching. Like, subscribe, send me an email. Send me an email if you want me to review a smoke that you're interested in, or you want to join me.